Commons Road, your brother, Sunday, Pastor Sunday, and like, put your hand together.
Hallelujah. Well, glory.
Amen.
Glad to be here. Yeah, she did. For over 10 years now. I was in Russia, and I wanted to be a journalist and to get my PhD. Come back to Nigeria and live a good life. But God was having a new, another plan entirely, which was to convert us to the ministers of the gospel. So that's who we are now. But before I start ministering the word of God to you, I would like to introduce my brother, one of my 13 assistant pastors. And he's the one who speaks English, so I decided to bring him. So he will come and say some few words to you, greet you, and tell you a little bit about what God is doing in our country of Ukraine. Amen. May God bless you. Pastor Michael.
God bless you, brothers and sisters.
Amen.
I greet you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And I want to say greetings from believers and from the people of Ukraine. It is one of the states that sprang from the former Soviet Union, USSR. It is the former communist Russia. So our church is in the capital of Ukraine. The capital of Ukraine, maybe you know, the city is Kyiv. And I came to God 2 years ago. I never sought God. I was very religious. I did many religious things like this. I have a strong faith that if I do this, the supernatural power that is in space will protect me and everything will be all right in my life. So it is the main belief of all the people in this land. So people do not know anything about Christ. So they hear about Christ, but they pay no attention. So I was in the Orthodox Church. You know Orthodox Church?
Yes.
The Catholic Church and the Orthodox Church. So I was many times in Orthodox Church. I saw crucified Christ. I saw the cross, but never I was interested in who is this person and what has he done for people. So one year it was interesting, but I started feeling something strange inside me. I began to seek something, but I could not realize what I was seeking. So I tried to find the answers on my problems in my life, and I began to learn something about supernatural. So I knew that there are spirits, that there is something, but that there is God who can speak with you, who can communicate, with whom you communicate. I did not know this. So I did not know that there is the word that he passed to the mankind. So I did not know that a man could find God. So I thought that the church is only the building when people play religious games. And one time I was watching TV and I saw one black man on TV program.
And
yes, in Ukraine. And I liked black very much. Why? Because I was I loved to listen to rap music, American rap music, when Africans sing. So I simply was interested. What this man can, what is he speaking about? And I began to listen to him. And one time or two times, it was enough for me to come to church. So I was arrested by the Holy Spirit. Because I immediately I understood that there is the very thing I was seeking, and there is the very thing that I should go there and obtain it. So I came to church, and since then my life changed tremendously. So I know that God loves me. I know the fellowship of the Holy Spirit. I know how God is speaking. I know what is it to believe in God. So, but there are many people in Ukraine and in the former Soviet Union who don't see God yet. Because, you know, this philosophy, materialism, do you know something about it? What is it? It is the kind of religion. People don't call it religion, but it is religion, because people base their knowledge and their faith upon this this materialism. So this materialism preaches that there is no God at all. Yes, and people who went to school, but in Ukraine, in Russia, all went to school, go to school. So they have been taught that there is no God. You know something about the theory of evolution by Charles Darwin?
Yes.
So my mind was so crippled by this theory that it was a major problem for me for the first year when I came to church. So I accepted God and I received God by faith, but I could not change my mind. But I could not do anything with my mind, because it is something that was implanted in your mind that spoils everything, spoils the understanding of God, spoils the understanding of His judgments and of His ways. So it was difficult, but Holy Spirit did His work. And now a person who was delivered from this delusion, person who was delivered from this oppressive spirit of materialism, who said that there is no God, that everything were generated by chance, you know, by chance. Yes, and it is very persuasive. I say very persuasive, because the spirit stands behind it. Spirit who persuades people that there is no God. It is the opposite side of the spiritual world. So, like Holy Spirit persuades people that there is God, there is faith in God, there is one God. So another spirit, whose name is the spirit of maybe materialism, yes, he persuades that there is no God. And people simply live their lives and they have no hope. The very desperate thing that was in my life is I could not imagine how I can die and there is nothing ahead. I could not realize. So God is great. Hallelujah.
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 And now he is doing his work. He is doing his work through TV. He is doing his work through people, through believers. And now this church in Kyiv is nearly 2,500 people.
Amen.
And this church has three services on Sunday.
Amen.
And every service is packed, and we have a hall that is for 1,000 people. So I am really blessed to be in Nigeria, to be in the mother country of our pastor. I have already said that people in our church have something from Africa. Yes, and the other Ukrainian people, when they see the members of our church, then can identify us with our pastor, with Africans. So we act as Africans. We do things as you. It is because one sparkle, spiritual sparkle or spiritual fire, was kindled the fire in one man from Africa, and he came and he was obedient to God, and he came and this little sparkle produced great fire, and this spirit that. Originated from Africa, this spirit, this anointing of the Holy Ghost, now is in Ukraine. And you can only imagine and realize what God can do through every one of you. If you will be obedient, and if you will listen to His voice, and will do what He will say to you. Yes. And I'm happy to be in your midst, and I bless you in the name of Jesus.